Teachers Coming to Stay.
It's the only show that puts the pupils in charge of the teachers.
There's lessons, F sharp, and challenges that all lead up to a final exam. If your teacher passes, your class wins an amazing prize. If they fail...
Sorry, guys.
It's a sickening splodging for the both of you.
10 press-ups.
Very nervous, very, very scared now.
Hello, you. I'm here in Yorkshire, and I tell you what, it's gorgeous here. I'm stood outside on primary school, where I'm about to drastically change the plans of one lucky pupil. Instead of going home and having a regular, boring time, they're going to be taking home their teacher. Will it be a laugh-a-minute comedy or an absolute horror show? Let's go and find out. Come with me. Our teacher and pupil are in there right now. It's showtime!
Right, Johny, you've done this quite a few times now. You know the drill. Just make sure you don't walk past the teacher. Oh, you've done it again.
Is Mrs. Cooper in here anywhere? Hello.
Hi.
That's a nervous grin. Mrs. Cooper, I've got a very special announcement to make for a young lad named Joe. Is Joe in here anywhere? Joe, come here if you'd just like to stand next to me. What did you have planned this weekend?
Nothing much.
Well, that's good, because you're going to be taking home your teacher, Mrs. Cooper, for the entire weekend. Now, Joe, it's not going to be like having your gran come round for the weekend, because you've got to teach Mrs. Cooper two of your favourite hobbies. And Mrs. Cooper, come Monday morning, you're going to sit a final exam on one of those hobbies. All you guys are involved too, because if Mrs. Cooper succeeds in passing that exam, then you'll all be going to an amazing day out at the Go Ape Adventure Park. But to make things a little bit worse, if you fail, you're going to get a massive gungeon from your whole class. Yeah! I tell you what, sounds like these guys would rather gungeon than go to the ape park. Hey,
oh, no.
Well, there's a lot of shock in this room. Let's find out a little bit more about our pupil, Joe.
Hi, I'm Jo and this is where I live.
I live here with my mum and my dad, my sister Ellie, and my other sister Lizzie.
We've also got four hens. That's Nerny, that's Tani, that's Amelia and that's Roma.
When my teacher comes, I'll make her clean out the hens. I'm a pretty chilled out kid. I take everything in my stride. Although I do have some pretty interesting hobbies. I do unicycling. I love unicycling, even play hockey on it. I also play saxophone. Jazz. Sometimes I like to show off and do both at the same time. Unicycle jazz. I do the Diablo,
juggling, and go on my trampoline.
I think my family think I'm too chilled out to become a teacher, but I'll show them. Okay, Miss Cooper, the bell has gone, so bring on pupil power.
Wow, Joe, a lot of circus skills there. You know, I once tried to run away with the circus, but they were all driving, so I couldn't keep up. Let's find out more about Mrs. Cooper.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Cooper, and this is where I live.
I live here with my best friend, Emma.
That's Mrs. Howcroft to you.
I'm a teacher too.
Because we're both teachers, there's an awful lot of marking to do. I'm really sporty, and I like to do street dancing. I'm running. I'm just really competitive, really.
Snap in your face, Havercroft.
All my friends think I'm absolutely crazy for doing this. The bell has gone, the pressure's well and truly on.
Mrs. Cooper, I bet you're gagging to find out which two hobbies you're going to have to learn by Monday morning, aren't you?
Yes. Gagging, yep.
Joe, do you want to put her out of her misery?
You're going to be learning how to unicycle and play the saxophone.
Great. Super.
Joe, are you up to the challenge?
Yeah, I should be, if she is a good pupil.
Now, I'm thinking at school, What do pupils usually have to have? I'm just... Any ideas?
School uniform.
A uniform, that is correct. Mrs. Cooper, we've got you your very own help teach school uniform. There you go.
Thank you.
Looking quite jazzy there, I'm sure it'll suit you. Are you okay about all this, Mrs. Cooper? You've been quite composed so far.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Yes, I'll go out and scream later.
So, Mrs. Cooper, the bell's about to go. If you'd just like to go and get your stuff, that'd be brilliant.
Thank you.
Jo, I know this all must be a bit weird for you. Tell the guys at home what's going through your mind right now.
Help! Teacher's going to stay!
Back in the staff room, Mrs. Cooper shows off her uniform to her fellow teachers.
Look what I have to wear.
Fantastic. Come on, Miss Cooper, it's time to go.
Oh, OK, Jo.
You look after my teacher, Jo, for this weekend.
Missing you.
Brilliant.
You good at music?
It's home time, but instead of heading out to play, Jo has to take his teacher back to his house. Lucky him.
OK, guys, I'll see you back at the house, yeah? Oh, no. A banana. I've seen those things on cartoons, and this could spell disaster. That was a close one, but should have known that kind of stuff only ever happens in cartoons.
Back home safe and sound, Jo gets stuck into showing off his humble abode.
This is my house.
Very nice.
This is the kitchen / dining room.
Hello.
This is my house.
Mum's happy now, but wait till Mrs. Cooper terrorises the house with her saxophone.
This is my living room.
Mmm, lovely.
This is my bedroom, which is actually tidy for once.
Very good.
And finally, this is your room.
Oh, it's lovely.
Place to put your own stuff.
Oh, excellent.
Meet me downstairs in 10 minutes.
Hey. Hi, Jo.
Looks like Mrs. Cooper could be having second thoughts. Too late now.
It's a bit odd being with Jo and his parents and his family.
I never ever thought that I'd actually have my teacher come to stay at my house. It feels quite surreal to have her actually here. Help, teacher's coming to stay. I said 10 minutes, you're late. Sit on the floor.
Sorry.
OK, I'm going to take the register. It's a good way for you to find out about my family. Mum?
Here.
Dad?
I'm sorry, he's absent.
Ellie?
Here.
Lizzie?
I'm sorry, she's absent as well.
Mrs. Cooper?
Here.
Johnny?
Here, Joe. Hey, he's good at this, isn't he? It's like he's been teaching for years. OK, now that you're all settled in and you both know your roles, let's find out how you're going to get on this weekend. It's time to play a little game. OK, now, this is very important. We need to see how compatible you are when it comes to teamwork. Bearing in mind that one of Joe's hobbies is unicycling, which requires balance, I'd like to introduce you to the Scales of Doom. What you've got to do, Mrs. Cooper, is find 10 balls that are situated around the garden. Mm-hmm. And place them in here to try and balance the scales. And you need to balance the balls on this tray here. Unfortunately, you're going to have to do it all blindfolded.
Oh, no.
That's right. Jo, you're going to have to guide Mrs. Cooper around the garden to find all the balls. Now, guys, there is one final thing. If you fail this challenge, you're going to be having leftover school dinners for tea. And I saw him earlier, and believe me, you don't want that to happen.
No.
OK?
Yeah.
If you'd like to don the blindfold. 3 minutes on the clock, and your time starts now.
Miss
off you
Cooper,
go.
Turn around 180 degrees. Go forward.
Come on, Jo. Put a little bit of effort in. You don't want those horrid leftover school. Oh, right into the bench.
Just bang the legs.
Very right.
Not very clear directions from Jo.
Forwards.
Because
stop.
They've got one ball on the tray.
Left hand,
well, so
crouch
far.
Down, left hand. OK, there. A bit in towards you, by your legs.
There. What does that mean?
I know. By I think legs. Joe needs to be a bit clearer with his directions.
Rested right. A little bit. That's
down.
30 seconds
down.
Gone, guys.
There.
Stop.
Go forward.
Sixth of the time.
Right. There. Yep. It's just rolled. There.
Yeah.
Right,
well
right,
so
right,
far.
Right. backwards, 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 backwards. Your right hand, go down, put your right hand.
I've got to say, I'm very
right
impressed
forward,
with Joel's
there.
Directional sense.
Okay,
seems to be directing Mrs. Cooper really well.
Backwards, backwards, backwards. Backwards, backwards. That's me.
Yeah. Okay,
I tell you what, I bet this morning when Mrs. Cooper arrived at school, she never imagined she'd be in Joel's back garden, blindfolded, getting balls into the scales of doom. Well done, guys. That's a minute 10 gone.
No, go, go. Okay, forward, 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 forward. Left, left. Turn. Yeah, forwards. Forwards, 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 forward, 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 forward. Go. Crouch down. Put your left hand out.
No, Joe, such in a cool guy, you. So composed. I mean, look at him. That is
there,
one cool
there,
dude.
Just where you had your hand there.
Got it.
Okay, go right.
Watch out for the camera, Mrs. Cooper.
Right and go forwards, turn a bit left. Forwards, 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 straight forward. Straight forward.
Get out of the way, camera
there,
guy.
There.
You better run. The scales of doom may get you.
So it's quite high up. In front of you, a bit more
this
forward,
looks like it might be quite
forward.
A difficult one
go,
for Mrs. Cooper to get.
Go left, there, there. Now, come to me, so go forward.
2 minutes gone, guys. Forward, the scales of doom forward, still aren't balanced.
Forward. Go to
it might be
right.
Leftover school dinners for these two if they're
forward,
not quick.
Forward, hold, and then there's...
Oh, yeah, got it,
bucket.
Got it.
Okay, then.
not quite balanced okay. Yet.
Are you going to need
go
one
forward,
more, guys?
Forward, forward. Forward.
You've got
go
40
right,
seconds left.
Right,
time
right.
Is running out.
Forward, 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 forward.
Oh, in the mud.
One
with those lovely shoes, too.
Left hand down. Left hand
you may laugh, Johnny, but you don't know how important shoes are to us ladies.
And that's perfectly balanced. Well done, guys. 2.5 minutes on the clock and you've done it. Well done. Well, listen, no school leftovers for you guys. We've got a lovely pizza prepared for you, so off you go and enjoy it.
Thank you.
You did really well, guys. Well done.
Thanks.
It was a bit scary being commanded at first around the garden, but it was okay once we got into it. I didn't like it, though, when you took me into the flower bed.
It's really weird telling your teacher what to do, but it feels good.
Mmm, those pizzas look lovely and well-deserved, too.
I want some of that pizza later, Mum.
You cheeky scamp! Anyway, over dinner, Joe reveals he's got a surprise lined up for Johnny and Mrs. Cooper.
You two are going to watch me go and play unicycle hockey.
Alrighty then. So, this is unicycle hockey, eh? Get off the pitch, Johnny.
I've got to say, I've seen a few hobbies in my time, but none as bizarre as this one.
No.
Ooh. Ooh. Ow. Ooh. It looks like quite a rough game as well.
Mm,
but they're always landing on the feet. Mm. Let's hope that you can do that as well, Mrs. Cooper.
You need to be pretty tough to play this game.
So, Ange, what is it about everyone playing unicycle hockey here?
I think one starts, another starts, and then they're all doing it. And they do all unicycle.
Do you think Mrs. Cooper will be able to pick up unicycling in the space of a weekend?
I hope so.
Oh, Joel's got a task on his hands. How long have you been playing this, Joe?
For around about a year.
A year, okay. I think tonight we should get Mrs. Cooper on a unicycle.
What? Did I hear Johnny say that Mrs. Cooper should have a go? Look at her face! She's not happy. He's a trouble causer, that one.
There we go!
Sorry.
Right, okay. You had human stabilisers then, Mrs. Cooper, and you still
and couldn't
stay upright. You still think you can do it after seeing that?
Yeah, hopefully.
I think you should have an early night tonight, because you've got
Definitely.
A long day ahead of you tomorrow.
Definitely.
Well, I think it's going pretty well for Joe and Mrs. Cooper. They passed the compatibility challenge, and they seem to be getting along well. Something's troubling me. I think Joel's more freaked out about having his teacher come in to stay at his house than he's letting on, and he's going to have to get over that hurdle if he's going to teach her those two very difficult hobbies.
I don't really know what will happen tomorrow. It'll be quite funny to watch a unicycle.
Unicycle hockey was a little bit scary. They made it look so easy, but not convinced, really.
Today's been really weird, but I think I can get used to it, kind of.
Quite strange for me, really, you know, knowing how to talk to him out of the classroom situation. So, something that we're going to have to get used to over the weekend, I think.
Unicycle. unicycle hockey. I wonder what other weird delights this place has to offer.
Hold on a minute. Is that music I can hear? I'd have never thought you'd have found a disco in the middle of the Yorkshire countryside, but hey, I'm here now, so I might as well check it out. Oh, hello, girls.
Oh, young man!
I think I'm in the wrong place.
Nonsense! Nonsense, come in!
Ah, here's a snuggle blanket.
Thank you. I'm just going to the toilet.
Don't be long now. This is a wicked tune.
I had to leave. I mean, I like to party as much as the next person, but it's getting late. I've got to be up in the morning. They're wild, this lot.
Who's up for the conga?
Yeah!
OK, leg it.
Coming up, will the power of being teacher go to Joe's head?
Time for us up.
Will Mrs. Cooper be able to take orders?
F sharp, F sharp.
Oh, man. This is ridiculous.
And Johnny has a shocking announcement.
I can't believe you're going to make it in your...
Ah, it's a beautiful morning in Yorkshire. The flowers are blooming, the birds are singing. Oh, and I think I can hear Mrs. Cooper screaming. Let's see what they're up to.
Wakey, wakey!
Morning, Jo. Morning.
You got to come and clean out the chickens and don't forget to wear your school uniform.
Right.
Loving your uniform.
Thanks.
You look very, interesting. OK, let's get to work on the chickens.
Great.
Cleaning out the chickens is normally Joe's Saturday morning chore, but now he's in charge, chickens? He's passed it on to his teacher.
Jo, they look quite clean anyway.
You haven't seen inside, let me see.
Oh, lovely.
Get to work.
There we go. This is disgusting.
You look like you're having a right good time.
Yeah, I'm really enjoying myself, Jo.
Mind you, if you had the chance to get your teacher to muck out some chickens, wouldn't you do it?
This is horrible, Jo. I really don't like you for this. This is disgusting.
I'm not cleaning that off. That can stay on. There, can I just leave that bit in? Because it's... I'm feeling quite sick now.
Morning, you two.
Morning, Johnny.
How are you getting on?
Oh, fine.
I'm fine.
Can you just hold that bucket for me?
Never felt
better. Mrs. Cooper, you look like you're enjoying that.
Oh, so, I'm having so much fun.
We'll leave you to it. Come on, Joe.
Yeah.
See you later.
See you later.
Oh, yeah, Miss Cooper, get some straw and put it in the bed.
Yes, sir. Joe is a lot more confident today, and I think he realises that he is in charge now.
So, now that you're the teacher, how are you feeling?
Watching Mrs. Cooper muck out the chickens this morning was really good.
Well, I reckon it's time for me to get your student. Are you ready to teach her your first lesson?
Yep.
OK, well, you wait there, Joe, and I'll go and get her. Oh, that Joe's such a cool kid. I think his calm exterior is really wearing off on me. Well, almost. It's school time! Help, teacher's coming to stay. OK, Mr. Joe, your pupil is ready for a first lesson. Thought it'd be good to start with timetable for today.
Timetable, what we're going to do is we're going to do some saxophone practice now. Then we're going to chill out and have some lunch. Mm-hmm. And then we're going to have some unicycle lessons.
Right, OK, well, I guess I'll leave you to it. You've got 45 minutes and it starts now.
Whoa, chill, Johnny, just chill. Sit down a bit, calm down.
Hang on, I thought chill time was later. Joe's chilling out already. OK, Johnny, they're never going to pass like this. Do something.
Good grief, if this is how things are going to be, I think you two could do some extra time in your lessons. Follow me. Right, I've brought you here to your beautiful local church because in there is a very special organist waiting to play a unique musical tune, the notes of which you guys have to find. Hidden inside the church are six musical lines that look like this. They're all individually numbered. You'll have to find them all and put them in the correct order for the organist to play. You've got 2 minutes to complete this, guys. If you fail, you'll be docked 5 minutes. But if you pass, you'll get an extra 15 minutes for your lesson. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Sound it, let's go in. So So there's our lovely organist. Anne, give us a wave, Anne. Lovely. Right, guys, this is a relay, so only one person will be going at a time. I reckon we should start with you, Joe. Your 2 minutes starts now.
Good, Joe.
How do you think he's going to do, Mrs. Cooper?
I'm hoping he'll do really well.
It's quite competitive.
Yeah,
isn't
he hasn't found one yet, though. How long has time gone?
15 seconds.
And he's hardly rushing around.
Quick, Joe. Look around here,
Can't find it. Yeah, he's struggling.
You've just run past one, Joe.
OK.
And do you think we'll be able to do it?
One more, is it?
I hope so. Hurry up, Mrs. Cooper. Well done, Joe. Are they quite
got another one.
Oh, Mrs. Cooper's doing well. This is where we see just how competitive Mrs. Cooper is.
Go.
Just chuck it on, it don't matter anyway. You can do it afterwards. That's a minute gone.
Oh, quick, Joe.
You're only halfway through. Well done. OK, you've got another one. Just chuck it on there. You can sort it out afterwards. OK. Oh, we've got another one. Well done, Mrs. Cooper. Come on. Check it on there.
We've got two more to find, Joe.
How do you think Joe's doing, Mrs. Cooper?
Pardon?
How do you think he's doing?
He's doing great. Have a look up as well as down.
Found Rob.
Gonna have to hurry you up. You've got
less than 30 seconds
left. And you've got two more to find. OK, one more to find.
Have you seen another one?
All right, Joe, you can be putting them in the correct order now. Right, three. Okay. You've got 10 seconds, Mrs. Cooper. Do you think she'll do it, Joe? Running out of time.
Come, Missy.
5 seconds.
I can't find it. Can't find it.
Hurry up.
No!
Your time is up. Your time is up.
Oh,
2 minutes on the clock. Commiserations. Just that last one, you did so well. Anne, could you play us what we've got so far? Almost there, that last line. Did you recognise the tune that Anne was playing there?
Yes.
And what was it?
Fever.
That's right. That is going to be the tune that you've got to learn on the saxophone, Mrs. Cooper. Fever. So get that implanted into your brain.
I will do.
Well, guys, I don't want to waste any more of your time. You failed this challenge, unfortunately, but I think you should get on with your lessons. Off you go. 5 minutes docked. Rather them than me.
And the first lesson of the day is underway.
Welcome to Help Teach School.
But before the full-on cacophony of saxophony, Jo shows Mrs. Cooper what she has to learn. And then gets on to a bit of sax theory.
These are all the different types of saxophones. So this first one is a contrabass. This one's the alto saxophone, which I play, and the sopranino.
Sopranino.
This is Courtney Pine.
Right.
And this is Snake Davis.
Snake Davis.
Which is my hero.
Really?
To put a reed on, it needs to be wet. So I want you to get 10 lolly sticks and lick them all so they're wet, OK? Don't do that, otherwise I'll give you 10 press-ups.
I need a lollipop on the end of it, then I wouldn't mind doing it. It'd be absolutely fine with a nice lolly on the end of it, but this is ridiculous.
Mrs. Cooper's been a bit cheeky. I think Joe's going to have to do something about that.
10 press-ups.
I'm doing it!
10 press-ups, otherwise I'll make you do 20. 10 press-ups. One, two...
This guy's teaching Mrs. Cooper doing the press ups. Good lad.
8, 9, 10. There we go. Now carry on. See, that's what will happen every single time you do something. Okay, here's the real thing.
What?
Yeah, very delicately. Here's your saxophone.
Wow.
Try and blow through it. Show.
Mrs. Cooper's finding it hard to even get a sound out of it at the minute.
When I first started blowing it, I was quite worried. I couldn't make a sound.
Oh,
when there is a problem, she'll blame it on the saxophone, not herself.
What's happening to it? There's something wrong with it.
It's not you.
It's not me.
It's a bit of a case of Paul Workman blaming his tools.
At the beginning, when I first picked it up, or hideous.
My ears are crying.
To be honest, I think I preferred it where Mrs. Cooper couldn't even get it to make a sound.
It's a bit sharp, isn't it? It does really, really hurt the lips. I wasn't really moaning, it was just tiring.
And it's really hurting my neck.
Stop whinging.
Joe did get frustrated with me a couple of times. I could see it in his face.
F-sharp, man. So,
Joe? I didn't really get frustrated as such. She was just whinging about her lips, how they hurt.
OK, then we've got 5 minutes left, so I'm going to teach you scat, which is a free form of jazz.
Scat? Like the scat man?
I'm a scat man.
Do it, that one.
Sort of.
He's got no idea what you're talking about, Mrs. Cooper.
Bebop, doobie 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 doo ah.
Dip to dip to dip doo dup a doo dup.
Doobie doo dup.
Okay, then that's enough of that. Let's get back to Learning Fever.
Okay?
Okay.
From the top.
Did you hear that? Check me, I can play the saxophone.
You reckon?
I was quite impressed with myself. I think I was a star pupil.
She's still got a long way to go.
Oh, I got it.
I don't know whether I'll be able to get it spot on by Monday. It's a big task, but I'll have a go. I just don't want to let the class down.
For homework, I want you to learn the D major scale. Now let's go and get some lunch.
OK. Help, teacher's coming to stay.
Guys! I know it's playtime, but come on, stop messing about. Take this seriously. It's on to lesson number 2 now. Remember, you've got 5 minutes less because you failed your challenge. That's only 40 minutes to learn how to unicycle. Let's hope you're better at that than playing the saxophone. Off you go, go on. Unbelievable.
Welcome to Unicycle Lessons. First of all, I'll give you a little demonstration of what you need to do. You need to be able to go a bit like this, just around that bar. Unicycling is all about movement and balance, so what I want you to do is hop on one foot whilst holding a glass of water. OK?
Right, OK. Hop on. Hey!
Ooh, check you.
Check me! Yeah, that's easy. I'm going to be great at unicycling.
Other foot.
Whoa! Oh, that's not so good.
OK, stop.
Mrs. Cooper's giving him a bit of back chat. He's going to have to sort that out.
10 press-ups.
Why?
10 press-ups. 1.
10 press-ups. And if it were me, it'd be on her knuckles.
4. Oh,
that'll teach you to flick water at your teacher, Mrs. Cooper.
7. 8, 9, 10. Well done.
What now?
You're going to have a go on the pedals.
OK.
This is a good training for the unicycle. Testing your balance and a bit of coordination.
Oh! Well, I got around once.
Yeah, it's quite hard.
Oh, yay!
You got it.
Yep.
OK, then. I think it's time to get your safety gear on.
Good lad, Joe. Safety should always come first. That's dead safe, that is. OK, that's pretty safe. I guess you can never be too safe.
And leave the helmet.
Thanks, Joe. No, perfect.
Good.
OK, Joe, how do I look?
Great.
Mrs. Cooper's just acting a little bit too cocky.
Before we get you your unicycle, I'm going to get my unicycling assistant, Adam, to help me.
Hi, Adam.
Hi.
OK. So, here is your unicycle.
Oh, excellent.
What I want you to do is put that under your bum and then put your left foot on the pedal, which starts around halfway,
and then hold on to me and Adam. There you go. And now, if you just try and pedal.
Sorry.
Oh, gosh, this is hard.
Oh, sorry.
You're doing well.
I'm stuck, sorry. Oh, guys.
The unicycling didn't go as well as I'd anticipated. It was so hard.
Hang on.
Okay, just try and go forward. Try and keep balanced.
Can't do it!
Well, Mrs. Cooper's losing it a little bit now, I think.
That's one thing with the uni, you must not get stressed.
Well, that's me out, isn't it, then? I'm not saying this.
Mrs. Cooper got angry because she couldn't do it and she don't really like doing stuff she can't do.
Am I actually getting anywhere?
Yes, you are, honestly. Are you ready to move on to concrete?
OK. Yeah.
So then, let's go.
I've got to be able to do this.
Say the words.
I can do it, I can do it, I can... Woo-hoo! Not do it. Sorry, guys.
I think Mrs. Cooper's feeling a bit frustrated. You did it! Mrs. Cooper got really frustrated and angry when she kept falling off.
Frustrated because I can't do it. I don't like this at all, don't I? I can't do it, Joe.
Keep and go. Keep and go. You're hardly using our support at all.
They were just supporting me all the time, so I don't know how I'm going to be able to do it. Really, really worried now. Really worried.
Stay calm.
Come on, Mrs. Cooper. You can do it.
OK, OK. Oh,
did you see that?
Time's up, Mrs. Cooper. You're getting better. Do you reckon you'll be able to do it by Monday morning, though?
Not convinced. Not at all, no.
No, me either. Adam, you think she's doing quite well?
Yeah, she's doing all right.
She's got a chance?
50-50.
OK, well, get off back to the house. I'll see you there. Help, teacher's coming to stay. Hey, up, you two.
Hi.
Hi.
How do you think today went? You're not too sure, Mrs. Cooper?
No, I was confident after the saxophone, but not with the unicycling anymore.
I think we need to expand our horizons a little bit. Well, you know how in York they have loads of street performers all the time?
Yeah.
Well, there's someone that I think we should watch perform there tomorrow. Do you know who that person is?
Oh, no. No, I don't think that's a very good idea.
It's you, Mrs. Cooper.
Oh, I really don't think that's a very good idea.
We're going to be going to York tomorrow and you're going to be performing what you've learned today on the unicycle.
Oh, no.
Yep, that's right. And the saxophone. How do you feel about that?
Not happy at all.
You're not impressed, are
you? No, not at all!
On that bombshell, I think I'm going to get out of here, leave you two to rest up for tomorrow, and I'll see you in York. See you later.
You're going to sleep well tonight, aren't you?
I can't believe you're going to make me do it in York!
After you can go shopping. I think we better practice. A lot.
So Saturday night comes to a close and Mrs. Cooper was not happy when we told her about that practice test tomorrow. On the plus side, Joe's really come out of his shell and started to teach with real authority. They made a bit of headway in the saxophone lesson, didn't do so well in the unicycling. Based on what I've seen today, tomorrow could be the most embarrassing moment of Mrs. Cooper's life.
I think Mrs. Cooper's feeling really cross and she's not happy with Johny at all.
I feel scared, anxious, stupid.
She looked truly appalled and I felt very sorry for her.
I'm not fancying it at all.
Coming up, has Joe taught Mrs. Cooper enough?
I've lost it.
Do I think I'll pass? No.
And will they win that all-important prize for their class? It's the morning of the practice test, and after all the tears, tantrums and tension from last night, let's hope a good night's rest has sorted everything out. Or maybe not.
I'm absolutely dreading it. I don't want to do it at all.
Oh!
Petrified, I think is the word.
I think she's feeling quite nervous.
Oh, God, I'm struggling today.
I'm quite annoyed at from the unicycle.
The unicycling is quite hard because she gets stressed with herself.
I don't want to do this, Jo. I can't do this one.
You can actually do this, honestly.
I've only got 24 hours left, Jo, if that.
Looks like the pep talk worked. Kind of.
Oh, no. OK, guys, time to go.
OK.
Good luck, you two. Sorry I can't be with you for the performance, but hope it goes well.
Ye old city of York, a town steeped in almost 2,000 years of culture. Everyone from the Romans, Vikings and Tudors have left a mark. Let's see if Mrs. Cooper can make such an impact.
Guys, good morning. Thanks for coming. Are you feeling OK?
No, I'm not. So no.
OK, here is the deal. You're going to have to entertain a crowd in the saxophone and the unicycling for a full minute. We'll gauge how well you do by how much money you earn. We'll donate all the money to charity as well. OK?
Mm-hmm.
Well, she's never going to forgive me. All right, OK, let's flip a coin to decide which one goes first. Heads, it's unicycling. Tails, it's the saxophone. And it's tails, the saxophone. You ready?
I'm ready.
Go and get your saxophone. Off you go.
Ooh. It's a tough crowd to please. York is notorious for street performers, so Mrs. Cooper best be good, otherwise they won't give her a second glance.
Mrs. Cooper, are you ready?
I'll have to be, won't I? Yeah, yeah, I'm ready.
Any final words?
Help!
Well, here we go. Ladies and gentlemen of York City Centre, performing the classic track Fever for the very first time, it's Mrs. Cooper. Please give your appreciation as to how much you think this show is worth with a donation. All money goes to charity.
Told you, they're even ignoring Johnny shouting at them. Poor lamb.
Away you go, Mrs. Cooper. Your minute starts now.
Go on, Mrs.
I've lost it. Hang on. Can I start again?
Yeah, you've still got 45 seconds.
It couldn't be going worse for Mrs. Cooper. She's forgotten her fingering and now her songbook has fallen off.
But I don't know without the music.
Time is up. Give her a round of applause, everyone. Mrs. Cooper, that
I'm
was
much interested.
Interesting. How did it feel?
Scary. It was OK.
I thought there were a couple of dodgy moments in there, to be fair, Mrs. Cooper.
Do you want to have a go?
No. Let's see how you've done. Nothing. A big, fat nothing. OK, it's time for the unicycling now. Go and get it. Right, Mrs. C, are you ready with your unicycle? I know you've been dreading this for quite a while,
haven't
you?
This is a bit that I'm just not looking forward to at all.
Well, I'll tell you what, just get it over and done with, OK?
Uh-huh.
Ladies and gentlemen of York City Centre, please show your appreciation as to how much you think this performance is worth. With a generous donation, all money goes to charity. Take it away, Mrs. Cooper.
Yeah, well done!
Oh!
Yeah.
Let's give a round of applause, guys. Let's cheer up. Come on. Come on. Oh. Try and get to me.
Come on, Missy.
This is cool.
Go on.
Come
on. Just go.
Oh.
Oh, nearly got you.
10 seconds left. Come on. Last go.
Without Joe. No, sorry, I meant.
And your minute's up, Mrs. Cooper. Give her a round of applause, guys. Brave. Any donations? Anyone?
Oh, thank you.
Oh, here we go. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Look at that, Mrs. C. And you were dreading this as well.
Check
and you've made
me.
A full.
Oh, look, more.
Oh, wow. Thank you very much. You've made a grand total of £3.06 that's going to charity.
That was probably the most embarrassing thing I've done in my life to date.
Yeah, I was pretty proud of her to say that she's learnt both of them in one day. But yeah, we needed a lot more work.
Cool. I think you've both still got a lot of work to do. So I suggest you get back to the house, grab a bit of grub. And I'll meet you there.
Just before lunch, Johny sets Joe and Mrs. Cooper each a secret challenge. If they succeed, they'll win themselves a special prize. What Joe has to do is say three weird words over lunch.
Those three words are economy, coupon, and tranquil. Anyone twigs what you're doing, you have failed, OK?
Mrs. Cooper, on the other hand, has to tell three lies during the meal.
Those three lies are, say that you're a world record holder.
Right.
OK. Say the elbows are the dirtiest part of your body.
Right.
OK. And say that York was originally pronounced fork. Now, you need to bring these in naturally, because if anyone calls you on a lie, then you'll have failed the challenge.
Yeah.
Off you go.
OK, thanks.
Good luck. Aha, let the games begin.
And they're off. Let the inane chitter-chatter begin. As always, Johnny's keeping watch on a monitor in the next room. Let's just hope he doesn't drift off. Oh, dear, we've lost him already. Johny, pay attention. That's better.
Do you know? Thank you. You know York used to be called Jorvik?
Yeah.
Well, way, way before that. They used to pronounce it fork. Fork, yeah, years, hundreds of years ago, they used to pronounce it fork.
Mrs. Cooper's really going for it. I don't think anyone's buying that, though.
Are you being serious?
Yeah, seriously. Seriously, cross my heart.
Somehow I don't believe that.
Oh, no. Joe's just said that he doesn't believe her. No prize for Mrs. Cooper.
Seriously, a long, long time ago, before Jorvik, before the Vikings came, before everybody. Seriously, they
used to call
it. Is that
because it was on the fork of a river?
It could have been, yeah, I don't know.
What did you buy
in York? Oh, I bought a dress for it.
What was Lizzie on about that, like, coupon voucher thing for a shop?
Joe is a genius. He's gone and got coupons straight away, and no one batted an eyelid.
Talking about money, when I was little, I got into the Guinness World Book of Records for raising the most money for a child to raise.
Did you?
Yeah.
How much did you raise then?
Raised £197. Oh. So, which
doesn't sound very much by night.
No, it's not much now, is it? No.
Don't you think it'd be like amazing for the economy if everybody did that?
Amazing. Joe's managed to flip Mrs. Cooper's lie about being a world record holder and getting the word economy. Genius.
Ow, itchy. Did you know? Oh, there's another fact for you. Your elbow is the dirtiest part of your body.
Here she goes again.
So quickly it picks up dirt. Well, quickly.
Cleaned off my table then.
Oh no, sorry. Yeah. No, I've moisturised, so it's okay. I've not got cracked elbows. But yeah. Pardon? I promise. Cross my heart. I promise you. The elbow is the dirtiest part of your body.
No one's believing her. Yep, a definite fail for you, Mrs. Cooper.
You know Prince Harry?
Not intimately, but yeah.
What's he doing with all these armies and stuff?
He's in the... which is he?
RAF.
He's in the RAF.
No, but isn't England quite a tranquil place, or peaceful?
Right, I think this game's well and truly over. I'm going to go and let Joe know that he's passed and Mrs. Cooper know that she's failed.
Hi, guys. How you doing?
Hi, Johny.
How was dinner?
Lovely, thank you.
Yeah, it seemed a bit odd to me. You have some random conversations in this house, don't you?
Yeah, I thought of that.
Honestly, I mean, Joe, what were you talking about? What was you talking about? The country's economy and coupon, you were saying, and tranquil. What was all that about?
Did you bring in tranquil?
Yes, he did. He did him very well, in fact, because I gave Joe all those three words to say.
Oh,
that's right. He's won himself a very special prize. In fact, I'm going to go and get it.
I think that was weird.
Here's a brand new hockey stick. There you go, Joe.
Wow.
Mrs. Cooper, you've made up some lies, surely. You were talking about the elbow being dirty.
No.
York was once pronounced fork, and that you held a world record. They were, of course, lies. And you had to buy them.
and you didn't.
And she could have won a brilliant prize for herself, but unfortunately, you failed, Mrs. Cooper. I'm so sorry.
It's okay.
Well, that's enough fun for now. We need to put the work in tonight because it's a big day ahead of us tomorrow. You've got the touch. You've got the power.
Yeah!
Bass.
Natural.
Sharp.
Soprano.
Soprano.
Courtney Pye.
Courtney Pye.
Snake Davis.
Snake Davis.
Snake Davis.
Look!
Yeah!
Scat!
Scooby-doo-doo-dibby-da.
Chubba-chubba-chubba-da.
Scooby-dee-scooby-da.
What do you think you're doing?
Sting.
Come on, we've got to practice unicycle.
Wah.
Wah.
Chi.
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 Well done.
I don't know. Let's go.
Oh!
Go on, Mrs. C, you're doing it!
Yay!
You all right, guys?
Yeah, thanks.
Yeah.
I'm glad to hear it. You know how this is school, help teach school, and it's just been like normal school, really, hasn't it?
Yeah.
We've had homework, we've had lessons. Well, if we also had a parents' evening, Mrs. Cooper, well, what do you think your mum would say about how you've been?
My mum would be really proud of me, I think.
You reckon? I'll tell you what, let's find out, shall we? Oh, that'll be our guest now. If you want to go up to your room, Mrs. Cooper, off you go. Joe, you come with me.
I don't understand parents' evening. Why is my mum involved? Is my mum involved? Why would my mum say anything? Oh, I don't get this. I don't like it either.
Hi, guys. Are you here for parents' evening?
Yes.
Well, our teacher Joe's ready for you now, if you'd just like to come on in.
Thank you.
I love this bit.
Hey, hi, I'm Mr. Joe.
How do you do?
Hi.
Hi, Mr.
And you are?
I'm Isabel, Mrs. Cooper's mum.
OK, and...
I'm Mrs. Hovercroft. I live with Mrs. Cooper.
OK, then, with the saxophone, she's very good at picking it up, but can boast a lot and a bit, like, cheeky.
When she was being cheeky, what did she do?
She pulled faces at me.
That's a bit mean, isn't it?
That's very naughty. And very naughty.
We'll have to have words with her when we get her home.
I think so, yes.
She's not as good at the unicycle, though.
Oh, I'm quite surprised at that.
I'm surprised.
Because I've been a dancer, I'd expect her to have good balance.
Yeah.
So how is she getting on with everybody?
She's getting on really well here.
Yeah. Oh, good.
Has she been behaving herself, though?
Yes, there's been two occasions when I've had to make her do press-ups.
Oh, right. Dear. I bet she wasn't pleased with that. Has she been going to bed on time?
Yeah, she has.
Oh, good.
Oh, I used to have terrible trouble getting her to bed on time.
Is she behaving herself at home?
Yeah, like you said, she can be a bit cheeky and stays up late sometimes, yeah. Especially on a school night. So, is it her final exam tomorrow?
Yeah, it is.
Will she be up practicing all night tonight?
Yeah, probably.
Oh, good. So, overall, is she a good pupil?
Yeah, she is quite good.
I'm good. Pleased to hear that.
Yeah.
A star?
A.
Hi.
Parents' evening was really funny.
Well, we've been hearing all about you, Mrs.
Yes,
Cooper.
We have. Yes, we have.
Parents' evening went very well. Not so well on the unicycle. I'm a little bit disappointed with Mrs. Cooper there.
Oh, I can't do it.
I'm sure you can.
Also, she's been a little bit cheeky and a little bit full of herself at times.
So. I'm not surprised about that, really. Are you?
Typical.
How are you feeling about tomorrow?
Really nervous.
Do you have to practice, Melissa?
You tried
really hard. OK, guys, I hate to break up the party, but it's your big day tomorrow, so if you can say your goodbyes.
OK. Bye, guys!
If I fail tomorrow, I think all of the class will be really disappointed and will enjoy the gunging.
Very nervous, very, very scared now. Do I think I'll pass? No.
School is out for another weekend here at Help Teach School. The final out-of-key note has been played and the last out-of-control wheel has spun. Or at least let's hope so, because tomorrow morning, Mrs. Cooper is going to have to sit that final exam in one of the two hobbies. Has she learned enough from Joe? I'm really not sure. I've got a feeling that this one could go either way. Help Teach is coming to stay.
Sun up at Joe's house on Monday morning, and the nerves are really kicking in for the looming final exam.
I am hoping I'll pass, but I'm not feeling too confident. As I was on Friday, yeah, I can do it, yeah, it'll be fine. Now I'm sort of feeling,
Are you feeling quite chilled out about today?
Yeah, I just don't want to disappoint everyone.
Oh, Jo, that's me too.
I'm feeling quite excited, but a little bit nervous.
I think the exam's going to be in unicycling, definitely. It's the one I feel least confident in, and no matter how much revision you do for any exam, it's always asking you questions on the things that you know least about.
Goodbye, you two. Have a lovely time.
Thank you.
Enjoy it. Thanks. And don't worry, it's going to be fine.
Thank you. See you later.
Bye.
Bye.
No more lessons, no more practice. What they've been working for all weekend is just around the corner. The hour of the final exam has at last arrived. Jo and Mrs. Cooper's class are filling the seats in hot anticipation of the result. There's no turning back now. It's prize or bust.
Right, that's it. There's no more practice time for Mrs. Cooper. It's showtime.
Good morning, everyone. How are you?
Great stuff. It's been an incredible weekend for Jo and Mrs. Cooper. They've busted their collective chops in order to try and win you guys an amazing day out at Go Ape Adventure Park. Yeah! Should we bring them out here?
Yeah!
Put your hands together for Jo and Mrs. Cooper! Guys, it's great to have you here. Come here. Oh, are there any butterflies in your stomach this morning?
Lots.
Okay, but overall, have you enjoyed this weekend, guys?
Yeah, really had fun.
Out of the two, unicycling and playing the saxophone, which hobby would you most like to be tested in?
Saxophone. Yeah, saxophone definitely.
Right, okay, well, I think it's time to find out which exam Mrs. Cooper is going to be tested on. Time for the golden envelope. Inside this golden envelope is the hobby that you're going to be tested on, Mrs. Cooper. You're hoping for the saxophone. The hobby you're going to be tested on in this final exam is playing the saxophone!
Yeah! High five, Jo!
Listen, you've not passed yet. Don't get too confident. Okay, now that we know the final exam is going to be in the saxophone, I know I may look a bit like a sax master. I actually know nothing about the saxophone, so I'm going to bring in an expert that can help me judge today. He's had loads of years of experience. He's played with the likes of George Michael, Kylie Minogue, and Amy Winehouse. He's a personal hero of Joe's. Put your hands together, everyone, for Snake Davis!
Snake Davis? The one they've been learning about in the lessons? How cool!
That was brilliant. Give a round of applause, guys. That was amazing. You're going to be helping me judge Mrs. Cooper play the saxophone.
Right.
What will you be looking for?
Well, I suppose in the circumstances, I'm not going to be really after technical excellence or a beauty of sound.
Okay.
But I'm going to be looking for a musicality, really, and an aptitude. I want to see that, you know, she has the potential to be like a great saxophone player.
Listen, don't be too frightened, because we don't expect you to be as good as Snake here. We do expect you to be quite good. Are you ready for your final exam?
Yes!
You're going to have to be. Here is the deal. This exam is going to be a best of five scenario. You need 3 points or more to pass. Some of the exam is going to be theory. Some is going to be practical. Mm-hmm. Okay, well, Jo, you can't help out anymore, so if you'd like to stand to the side, let's bring on Mrs. Cooper's sax. Beautiful instrument.
Thank you.
Are you ready for your first task? Mm-hmm. I want you to play a scale in D major.
Major. Start again.
I unfortunately can't let you do that, Mrs. Cooper.
Okay.
I'm sorry. Snake, was that a pass or a fail?
Well, c- kind of started off all right. I thought it was going to be okay, but then it crumbled really. So I'm really sorry, guys. It's a fail.
Sorry, guys.
Okay, task two is a theory question. Which is the largest and the smallest of the saxophone family?
The largest saxophone is the contrabass and the smallest is the sopranino.
Sounded good to me, Snake. What do you reckon?
Spot on.
It's a pass! So it's task number three. I want you to play the tune of Fever. Was that correct, Snake?
I think, although there was one or two slightly wrong notes, the tune was there. It's jazz, you know. Jazz is full of funny notes. So I'm trying to give her a pass, because the tune...
Yeah, So that's two correct. We've got two tasks left. You need to get one of these two correct, otherwise you'll fail. Okay. Task number four. Over the course of the weekend, Joe has been teaching you a form of improvised jazz. What is this known as? And please give us a demo.
The improvised form of jazz that Joe has been teaching me is scat.
Give us a demo.
Scooby-doo, biddy-bee, billy-bop, billy-bop, shadooba.
Snake. Pass or fail?
That's a pass, isn't it?
Yes!
Well done! You're welling up a bit there, aren't you, Mrs. Scott?
We've done it, guys. We've done it. We're going!
This weekend's been absolutely fantastic. I don't think I've laughed so much in a long time.
I felt really proud of Miss Cooper and quite proud of myself.
Well done, Joe, you did it.
Things I've learnt about Joe is that he's such a caring and kind-natured boy. When I got upset about things, when I couldn't do tasks, he was always supporting me. He is an amazing kid. He's been a superstar.
That was a thriller.
It was a great pass. I think they both definitely deserved to win.
Of course they did. Join us next week for more pupil-teacher switches in another Help. Teachers coming to stay.
See ya.
Calling all pupils of Great Britain.
Could you teach your teacher a thing or two?
If you've got a brilliant or unusual hobby that you'd like to teach them,
then you need to go to the CBBC website
and click Be On A Show.
Teachers coming to stay.